You guys, football may be the biggest thing going on right now here on Earth, but what about in space? Do they get to see the matches too? Hey world, Trace here for DNews, and this is your weekly space update. You can be sure the astronauts flying on the ISS are trained both physically and mentally for their journey. They're required to exercise daily, they have to run experiments, perform spacewalks, and fulfill duties at all hours of the day. But NASA ensures that they are not just worker bees, that they get to take care of their psychological needs as well. They have a way to uplink movies that aren't already up there. But what about other things like the Super Bowl, Olympics, the World Cup, US Open, the World Chess Championship? Dude, Magnus Carlsen is defending his title this year. Everyone in the world, and some people in the United States, are going balls on the pitch crazy about the largest, most watched sporting event on the planet, the World Cup. And seeing as this is the International Space Station, we've probably got some football-loving astronauts. So, NASA's Johnson Space Center is on the case to make sure that these intrepid explorers get their psychological needs met. A NASA representative told us the final match of the World Cup falls during off-duty time on a Sunday, so they might choose to watch some of the game live. So they do get to watch it. Another press release showed astronauts enjoying a 10-minute highlight reel earlier this week, so they are definitely up on the biggest sports Earth news this week. And they're interested in watching. But technology isn't magic. They can't just swipe a TV show up to the clouds and have it fly to the space station. The ISS has to have a Ku-band connection with mission control. It's called the Ku-band because it's directly below the K-band on the electromagnetic spectrum. Ku, K under. Get it? The 12 to 18 gigahertz Ku band isn't just for sending fast and loud marathons to the ISS. It's also used for satellite communications and television broadcasting. The ISS uses the Ku because it has a higher bandwidth than their normal internet uplink, so it's ideal for sending large amounts of information like a live broadcast. Johnson Space Center has a special license from their satellite cable company to redirect channels that astronauts want to see directly to the ISS. Like cell phone service on the ground, though, the Ku coverage in space varies. But the ISS is usually able to connect to the Johnson Space Center for 80 minutes of each 90-minute orbit. That's a long 10-minute blackout during an exciting sports ball match, but if they're not streaming something live, they can use it for other things too. So that's awesome. Let's just say for kicks that no one was interested in the World Cup. Astronauts don't just sit around watching the tube, they also use their computers to surf the web or call home, they play musical instruments, they read, and so on and so forth. These are all important aspects of psychological support for astronauts on long-duration missions. That's according to our friendly NASA representative. They can even watch movies together in their makeshift movie theater. It's really silly. In fact, according to NASA, there's a growing collection of DVDs brought up by past missions. Watching the Star Trek series was a weekly event for former ISS astronaut Greg Chamatoff. So that's kind of fun too. If you could take three movies with you to the ISS, which three would you take? Tell us your movies in the comments and subscribe. But before you go, if you're a space geek who likes to space out and learn about space, next Tuesday, June 24th, we are doing our monthly Google Hangout with NASA JPL. Did you know that they don't just look up at the stars? They also care a lot about what's going on down here on good old terra firma. We're gonna talk with some scientists working on the Earth science missions. It's gonna be so awesome. Check the description for your link to RSVP and get your questions ready. Thanks for watching again. See ya.